It is spring in Vermont. Gorgeous day. I am on my way to Bellows Falls, Vermont to see the good folks at Silver Forest.
Silver Forest jewelry has been handcrafted in the USA for more than 40 years. They design, create, and distribute their enchanting wearable art to more than 5,000 retailers. Silver Forest has been using MISys with Sage 300 since 2012. They rely on advanced purchasing, advanced production, and MRP.
My parents started the company as hippie crafters in the 70s, honestly.
Really?
Yeah. So they met at New Paul's College and moved up to Vermont, and they got to the first town, Brattleboro, and they decided, okay, we're here.
Hippie culture too, yeah.
Yeah. And so they started doing craft shows, basically.
As we continue the tour, I begin to truly appreciate what it takes to build and maintain a successful jewelry manufacturing business.
You know, we try to make to forecast. You know, we don't have the staffing or the bandwidth really to be doing a lot of expediting and building for order. Yeah. So we'll run a pretty long forecast period, like a 6-month forecast period, where we're buying raw materials. And if my sales plan and my forecast should match up really closely at the unit level. If we're executing, we're coming in at like 95 to 105% of our plan. So we're basically building to the forecast schedule, completing that, moving on to the next one.
With no room for a miss, every step of the way is carefully planned out and implemented.
Every month I'm running 5 discrete schedules. So, you know, the first schedule I'm running is just raw materials. Yeah. This is my demand for 6 months of raw materials. Then MISys is gonna tell us what we have on hand at raw and all the way step and say, this is what you're gonna need for raw materials. And I'm gonna give my subcontractors or my suppliers 2 months basically to get those raw materials to us. Then we're creating a schedule for all of our subcontractors. Yeah. Right, that are taking those raw materials and they're plating them, they're soldering them, they're gluing them, and they're doing a few steps.
Yeah.
Then I'm going to create another schedule of more kind of work in process schedule for what we do ourselves, which is all the painting, all the final assembly, some other very special processes.
Yeah. We learned that in this business, the margins are low and competition from countries like China is fierce. So how does MISys help Silver Forest compete?
I find it to be incredibly accurate. To me, that's the most important thing. And so I have kind of used MISys in a way that fits my business and the cycles that I've done, which is really has to be very efficient. So I move everything in monthly buckets, right? And then whatever's not completed or initiated, I'm able to kind of throw away and start again. So MISys, because of the accuracy and because I find it, once it's set up properly, really easy to execute on. Yeah. We burn all our old MOs. We create a whole new set of net requirements. Yeah. And what's not completed in the month, we run our fresh schedules again. Mm-hmm. And I can only do that with, you know, accuracy.
Right.
Success at Silver Forest requires attention to detail. Input from different people is critical, and flexibility with data is a must.
So that's, you know, there's two things that I really like about mice. I mean, there's many things, but two of the things I like, is the ability to export the master files, to get at a bill of material and just kind of look at it the way I like to look at it in an Excel spreadsheet, or to capture inventory value over a period of time and just continually do a routine that downloads the raw data.
Yeah.
So I find that really useful. Another thing I really like is this, what we call Testco, this ability to replicate our company and then to play in the sandbox and say, what's gonna happen if I do this to my schedule? What's gonna happen to my capacity if I do this? And to actually replicate my schedules in a sandbox outside, but using the data that I had this morning. For me, that's great. I do that all the time. Testco is really an excellent tool for management to decide if we're going to take a project on or how we're going to proceed with something.
Yeah.
Attention to detail is in everything Silver Forest does. Quality is imperative. And with so many items in motion, everyone needs to be clear on what to build and how to build it.
I think when it comes out of design, they call it a recipe.
Yes.
If it's not being done well, it's called the laundry list. But ultimately, it's supposed to become a bill of material, which defines every single item in that part. And for us, we're selling, you know, our earrings are wholesaling for less than $10. And they can have 30 different parts that each have three different. And we don't just sell one, we sell a pair.
Yeah. Right.
So we got a pair with all those different parts and processes. So it's really very important that when we know what we're building and how we're building it, and it's somewhat an autopilot every month.
Right.
With millions of items in stock over years of time, MISys provides a convenient repository to keep data stored and organized, which provides a way to keep everyone, staff and vendors, on the same page.
You know, another thing that I use myself and I find really helpful is at the item level, being able to not just have a spec sheet PDF attached, but we're also able to have an image attached.
Yes.
So sometimes a spec sheet's not going to give you all that visual cue that we need.
Right.
So to be able to have like a scaled image attached there, go to the item, we can see what we're talking about, look at our whole configuration, say, hey, those two things aren't matching up, and figure out, you know, we can quickly get to an issue versus having to pull all these old spec books and get the dust off of them. It's such a great tool. And then if I'm ever kind of having a conversation with a vendor, I don't have to go to engineering and say, can you pull me all this? I can just pull it, or I can just put it into a little folder and email it off. And so that's another part where it's just like, I have all these pieces of data built into the system. And if I want to pull it out to do something, I'm not going to have my suppliers go to MISys, but I surely can send them a bunch of PDFs that are sitting all there in a way that works for me.
Right.
As we follow Ben through his facility, it's overwhelming to imagine how many items are coming in and going out month after month. Yet with MISys integration with Sage 300, his accounting, his books are completely balanced.
The seamless integration with Sage 300. So, like I was saying, as complex as this is, and our manufacturing's, you know, at the heart of what we do, we're also selling to thousands and thousands of customers, and I got to run financials every month. I got to have my invoicing. I have to have my SKU management, my UPCs. And so that integration with Sage 300 ERP has been tremendous.
Great.
And the fact that it's so seamlessly integrated that once I get my month closed, and that happens the night of the final night of the month, in about 2 or 3 days, I can kick out my financials. It's really remarkable.
That's pretty good. Yeah.
So how does he keep his finances straight? Ben explains.
My inventory is really accurate. The value, not just what I have has to be accurate.
Yeah.
The value of what I have could be a little bit more squirrely, but that's also very accurate.
Thanks to Ben Madow and his team for the tour and for sharing with us how Silver Force uses MISys integrated with Sage 300 as a powerful tool to manage their manufacturing processes with accuracy, which allows their business to thrive. To learn more about MISys manufacturing, visit us online at MISysInc.com.